What's me top stuff about video on the channel, and today I am doing a Minecraft PvP client tier list for 1.8.9. Actually, I'm pretty sure some of these clients for 1.8, but you know, you get the idea. So it's essentially Minecraft PvP clients for Hypixel, since some of you guys like to play on Hypixel. So aside from that, guys, make sure to subscribe for more Minecraft PvP client related videos and more Minecraft videos in general. Now this is actually my second time recording this, so I'm kind of exhausted, so I'm going to have to speak everything about these clients. Anyways, so I gathered a bunch of clients that I've reviewed in the past, and I didn't get all of them because that would equal up to like 34 clients, and most of the clients are either skidded or just not worth your time until they update it with their, you know, whatever. But yeah, guys, so aside from that, so let's go over some of these Minecraft PvP clients. Hey, how's it going there, Forge? So, S tier. You might be wondering why I put Forge in S tier. Well, considering that it's the most popular client choice out of all of them, yeah, of course I'll put Forge up there. Also, Forge, you can add in any mods you want, you can remove any mods you want. Me personally, I just have three mods, the Patcher mod, the Better FPS, and Optifine, and also Replay mod if you really consider the fact that you put mods there. But yeah, Forge is like the only version they can actually legally add Replay mods, so I mean... Anyways, Skull Clients, D tier. That is like the oldest client out of all of these and the most outdated client out of all of these, I think. So, you know, like, if you're still using Skull Client, stop it. Just don't stop using Skull Client. Skull Client is so old. PvP Lounge. A tier, I like PvP Lounge. I think it's a good client. I don't know about you guys, but I enjoyed PvP Lounge when I played it. Yeah, it's a very good client. I enjoyed it. You can go check my, you know, videos on these clients once again. I don't know my initial reaction for a lot of these, so I'm going to have to, like, remember based off of memory. PvP Lounge had a lot of unique aspects to it. It was a very good client. I liked the client a lot. It was just an overall good client in general. Alright, so I kind of stopped the recording because I completely forgot to add in a client. There it is right there. I forgot to add in that client real quick, so I kind of realized that, so I kind of just paused the recording. And now we're resuming, but for now let's go over the Cosmic Client. It's a C tier. The reason why it's a C tier is because the main issue that I have with the Cosmic Client is that it's so server-based. That's the main reason why it's in C tier. It's based around factions and all that, so most of the mods are suited for factions, their server. Yeah, like, they even have an event list, which is supposed to be for specifically their server. Overall, go to client, it's just that, you know, if you're playing Cosmic PvP, that's, you know, like, it's only good for that, really. But, yeah, Cosmic PvP is still a popular server, so yeah. However, let's go over another faction's client and why it's in the D's here instead of Cosmic. See, the thing is with the Crystal client is that it's a faction's client, but the problem with that, you know, design for the faction's client thing is just that Cosmic is a faction's client in itself, and it's for Cosmic PvP, which is probably the most popular faction server. Now, with Crystal, it's partnered with three faction servers that are already, like, dead, and not to mention, the client itself could easily get you banned on some servers if you forget to turn off your minimap, because the minimap, you're not allowed to have a minimap for Hypixel, at least in some games, especially if they show the player icons, which in that case, you're really screwed then. But aside from that, like, Crystal Client, it's a very, very, very good client. It's just that for the purpose that it has, you might as well just go with a different client. Labies mod, A tier. By far, one of my favorite clients. The Labies mod client is very, very good because it's a client that is very similar to Forge, in which you can adjust a lot of things. You can install mods directly towards the client, and you can also remove mods and all that. And yeah, like, the mods in Labies mod are very, very good, and some of them are, like, very underrated mods as well, or mods that you have never heard of ever, but are very, very good for Minecraft PvP. And you can just have a whole heap of mods that are suited towards you within one client. The downside of Labies mod is that some of the mods that you might install are bannable in some servers for unfair advantage. Like, I think there's the one with the heart showing above, like, the person. That is bannable in some servers due to unfair advantage. So it's a very, very good client, but because it's bannable, I'm taking it down one tier. Aside from that, let's go over to the Technics client, and I'm going to put that in the B tier. Now, Technics client is a very good client, but the problem with the Technics client is that it's not very astounding. It's very good. It does what it needs to do. It's very nice. I liked what they did with this client. It's just that it wasn't a big wow factor, I guess. It wasn't a very, oh my god, this client is so good kind of thing, you know? It's just okay. It's a very good client. If you want to try it out yourself, go ahead. You know, you might check out the other clients and think that they're more, I guess, in-depth than the Technics client. Blazing Pack clients, I'm going to rate this as... I'm going to put this in the D tier because Blazing Pack clients, I mean, the main issues all come from the fact that this is a Polish client. Yeah, I just don't know why they don't have any other language for this client. Like, I saw some of the stuff in this client and it's not in English, meaning that they don't have translations for people who speak English. And also there was a minimap that you could easily get banned for, based on what I've heard. It's a good client. It's in the DCA because of a bunch of limitations for English speakers, along with the fact that it just is technically bannable in some aspect. Okay, sorry, but I paused once again because I forgot to add in Salver client. So the Salver client is a client that is very, very good because it allows you the ability of playing on Cracked. People love to play on Cracked. Hey guys, this is the best Cracked client in Minecraft. Play it. Don't freaking bother me with your crap. But yeah, it's overall the best Cracked Minecraft client. And yes, it's a very, very good regular Minecraft PvP client for any person that has, you know, like a Microsoft account or Java account, whatever. Overall, it's just a very nice client. And yeah, it's just amazing how Salware, you know, managed to have this adaptability for people with, you know, if you have a Minecraft client, if you have a Minecraft cracked like account, if you have a Minecraft, regular accounts, Java, you know, Microsoft, it affects the PvP experience for everyone, and it gives people the ability to play Minecraft, you know. So overall, A tier, but in terms of like overall like Minecraft clients, I don't think that it's the best Minecraft client. I don't think that it's like the best Minecraft client for like people that who pay for the game. They have better options, and that's my main thing. So good a client, but you know, people could look for other clients as a better alternative. Melon clients, B tier, but a high B tier. Melon client is a bit of a weird client for me because it's a very good client. When I tried it out before, it's a very good client, but the reason why it's in B tier is that even though it has that wow factor, it hasn't been updated in a long while when it's said that people are going to update this client. It's such a good, promising client, and it could be the next client to make it into the S tier, but the problem is the lack of updates, the lack of attention, the lack of, you know, focus on improving the Melon client. I mean, there's no, like, you know what I mean? So, yeah, that's why Melon client's not going to be put up in the S tier. So yeah, now we're down to the last six clients, about to be five once I put the Ares clients into the B tier. So the Ares clients is a very good client. I like the clients. I think I've said this before where, like I said, that it's a very good client, whatever. It's just that there's, once again, you know, better options than the Ares clients. And the Ares clients did get an update recently, but I don't think that's enough for them to be in the A tier. Like, the update, I hardly even noticed the update, really. I'm gonna be honest with you, I hardly ever noticed the update. People have been saying that I missed a whole page of things, and maybe that page of things, like the page of mods or whatever, maybe that could have pushed it up into A tier, and I'm just being an idiot. That could be true, but overall, I just can't see how it could possibly pass even Salvia, which gives people the flexibility of playing on any, you know, on any type of accounts that they have. Bat mod, Batmon is such an awkward place because I want to put it in A tier, but at the same time, I don't think that it belongs in A tier. I think high B tier for the Batmon. And the Batmon's a very good client. I like the Batmon. The Batmon was very, very nice. It's just that I feel like the Batmon, it's, even though it's a very good client where you can customize it a lot, I think that there's like still some better options to pick than the Batmon. Some people looked at the client and thought that it was copying off of someone else, which those are rumors. I don't know if that's true or not, so I'm not gonna put up an A tier until I figure out if like that's true or not, because I don't know. In that case, it'll belong in the C tier, or if it's just rumors, then I would put up an A tier. But for now, I'm just gonna leave it B tier, and maybe I'll do this again. Who knows? Once I review more clients and whatnot. CM pack C tier. The CM pack. I've been seeing the CM pack, and it looks like a hybrid between Ares and Batmon, I think, and people notice that as well, where it looks like it's Ares plus Batmon. I don't know why. Just doesn't feel very good. The layout is very weird with like the mod list, because like when you're trying to find a specific setting, you scroll down for like ages trying to find this setting. The fact that it has like a very similar appearance to the Ares 2 client, this is the second version, it kind of makes me concerned as to like if they copied off of Ares or not. Maybe it's the other way around, but at the same time, I don't think it's the other way around because Ares updates frequently. So yeah, I just think that the CM pack is a fringe C to B client, but I don't think that you should use the CM pack over some of these clients. Illenium clients, I'm gonna put you up in A tier. See, my initial reaction to the Illenium clients was really good. I like the Illenium clients. Me personally, I find it slightly distracting occasionally with its like particle inside of the inventory, but it looks clean. It looks super nice. I like the way that it looks. The appearance of the Illenium client is the main reason why I put it in A tier, because it works. The client works. It's a very good client, and it's just so good. The looks and appearance of the client is very nice, very sleek, very cool, and I just enjoyed my experience with the Illenium clients. So now for the final two, and I'm just going to tell you right now that they're both in S tier, but Badline is going to be below Lunar because, I mean, this is kind of obvious, but Lunar is more popular for, you know, obvious reasons, and in my experience, I think Lunar is definitely the better client between Badline and Lunar. So, yeah, I'm not going to, like, sugarcoat that. But anyways, that is my tier list. So, here it is. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video, like, you want to subscribe, and hit subscribe. Remember to be a top. I'll see you guys next video. Take care and good.